Okay, so continuing with boss number 4. We're gonna go to armor part number 4 here in the Street stage. Unfortunately, we don't have the favored weapon, Forsting Chameleon, but it's alright, because this armor upgrade reduces the amount of damage it should take, and it should be just enough for me to take him with just the Buster. Alright, so this sub-boss here unlocks the capsule. Gotta sort of use on him the same strategy that you would another boss, just stay on the opposite side of the screen. You can only blast him in the head, so be careful, body shots are gonna bounce right off. Yeah, he'll try and grab you if you get too close, but it really is just easy to just stay away from him. Yeah, so he starts as he's taking damage. I'm not sure what that trophy's all about. But that must just be a counter for actual body armor. Or it might be the first completed set of armor. Yeah, that's what I'll do after I get away to these things. Careful, this is quick scan here. So you notice how he's sinking. You don't want to do that. So he should jump out every so often. Alright, so the trick with this guy, since you don't have the upgrade, is just, you know, standard, stay on the other side of the screen from him. But he does turn kind of invisible, but you can see where he's moving. So, yeah, you just try to avoid him as much as possible. Oh yeah, and then he'll swing from the roof. There. bottom. Flashes on the ground, just try to stay away from his tongue. His tongue only extends so far. Oh, speaking of ceiling spikes, don't jump all the way up the wall. That is a spike ceiling. I don't think it's insta-kill, but you will take damage. I think. Yep. Oh, come on. You know you want to take one last shot for me? Devastating and pink, that must be for beating up the boss with a charge shot. Alright, so with all four armor pieces out of the way, we have successfully moved on to the point where now we will be using the good weapon against all the bosses.